Welcome, students, to the tutorial on how to register for courses and drop courses in myHilltop. Students, you are required to meet with your advisor in order to obtain your alternate PIN prior to registering for courses. This is replacing the registration clearance previously done in EdWeb. This may also be referred to as your registration PIN. The alternate PIN is required for all registration functions, including adding and dropping courses. Should you misplace or forget your alternate PIN, you will need to contact your advisor. The alternate PIN is a unique 6-character code which will be given to traditional undergraduate students during the advising session. Alternate PINs will consist of 2 alpha characters and 4 numeric characters which will define the term of use. For example, an alternate PIN issued in the fall term would follow this format, FA8945. An alternate PIN issued for use in the spring term, SP7632. An alternate PIN issued for use in summer term, SU9272. Please note, alternate PINs are only used for 1 semester. You will need to contact your advisor each semester for your new registration alternate PIN. Once you have obtained your alternate PIN, you will need to log in to myHilltop. To begin, visit think.stedwards.edu, and from the quick links listed on the right, click on myHilltop. Log in with your current St. Edwards username and password. Then click on Login towards the bottom left of the screen. Once you are logged in, you will navigate to the student link from the myHilltop landing page. From the student page in myHilltop, select Add Drop a Course located beneath the Registration Tools header on the lower left side of the page. You will first be prompted to select the term of registration. Once you select the term, click Submit. All subsequent menu items you select relate back to the selected term. You must select another term to view information related to your new query. A similar screen will appear. You will then be prompted to enter your alternate PIN. Make a note that alternate PINs are case sensitive. Use the corresponding PIN to the term. Once you have entered your alternate PIN, click Submit. The Add Classes worksheet, that is the registration form, will be displayed. Click on Class Search to open the search function. There are 2 ways to search for classes, Course Search and Advanced Search. The Course Search is the standard search method which will display all the courses in undergraduate, graduate, and new college. For the purposes of this video, we will utilize a simple course search. Advanced search will allow you to search for specific courses by days of the week or instructor. Use the scroll bar to navigate through the menu and highlight the subject you wish to find. For example, you may select accounting under the subject and then click course search. The search will list all of the accounting courses that are offered this semester. Scroll through the list to locate the course number you wish to view in the schedule. Please note that new college courses are followed by an A. For example, Accounting 1 would have a course number of 2301A. Click on View Sections to view the available sections for the courses offered this semester. You will notice a course reference number, CRN, associated with each course. The CRN is a unique identifier which is randomly assigned each registration period to individual sections of a course. Select the CRN you want to add to your worksheet. Once you have selected your CRN, you now have 2 options. For immediate registration of the course, choose the Register button. Or if you prefer to register for all courses at once, click Add to Worksheet. You will notice that only the CRN has been pre-populated into the Add Classes worksheet. To enter another course, select Class Search. Select the next subject you wish to explore, then click Course Search to repeat the preceding process. Repeat the process until you have selected all corresponding CRNs for each course in which you wish to enroll. Then click Submit Changes when finished. Once you have clicked Submit Changes, you have successfully registered for classes. Please make sure to return to myHilltop and select the Billing and Financial tab and access the Bill Center where you may view your bills and make a payment. You may receive other registration messages when attempting to enroll in courses. These may be due to a course requirement, GPA, test score, or program requirement. Check the course description to see what requirements are for the course. These are some examples of possible registration errors. You have holds which prevent registration. You have not met the requirements for this course. a time conflict with a CRN previously selected, and the course cannot be added. Next are instructions on dropping a class. Students, as a reminder, if you have exited the registration screens, you must log back into myHilltop and select the Add Drop a Class link. Once you are registered for courses, they will be listed. Notice that each course has a drop-down box in the action column. Click the drop-down box to see the list of options related to that class. Your choices will vary depending on the date in the semester. For example, if you are dropping a traditional 16-week course before school starts, you will need to select Web Unrecorded Drop to drop the course. You will not be charged for the course. If you are dropping a course after the official headcount day for the term, you will need to select Withdrawn to drop the course. Please refer to the Student Financial Services refund schedule for specific refund dates. You must click on the Submit Changes button to actually drop the course. Your drop is not finalized until this step has been completed. You may no longer drop a course after the posted last drop date deadline. For specific term deadlines, refer to the Office of the Registrar's Dates and Deadlines box in the student page of myHilltop. Remember, once you are done viewing all your student information in myHilltop, it is important to sign out. On the top right side of the screen, click on the Sign Out link. For questions related to training, please contact training@stedwards.edu. For questions regarding specific student or faculty content, please contact the Office of the Registrar at 512-448-8747. For technical support, please contact the IT Computer Help Desk at 512-448-8443 or email support@stedwards.edu.